Hey everyone, welcome back to Lace Up Channel. My name is Mickey. Today we're going to cover everything about the profit and loss. I get distributors all the time that have acquired new businesses and they're like, Mickey, we really want your system. We think we're going to grow this business to infinity. In my head, the wheels are constantly turning. I'm trying to think about why would anyone take their hard-earned capital to put it into a business that's competitive, where the profit margins are low? And the conclusion always comes back to, well, it must be because their profit and loss is on point. So in this video, I'm going to show you exactly what is a profit and loss. Why is a profit and loss important? What does an actual profit and loss look like? And if you are in the process of acquiring a business, a distribution business, a manufacturing business, what you need to look out for in the profit and loss to ensure that you're making the best possible decision for yourself and your family. Anyways, let's get right into the video. So a profit and loss is a statement or report that shows you the income of a business. It shows you the cost of goods sold, gross profit, expenses, other incomes, and the net operating income. So if we go into each of these fields, I'm going to define them for you. The income of a business is a business's revenue. It's gross invoices. All the invoices sent out to customers for which the customers pay, and that money gets deposited into the business's bank account. The cost of goods sold of a business are the costs of the items that were sold to the end consumer. So for instance, if I'm a reseller of bananas and I've got a banana that cost me $3 and I go and I sell that banana for $5, well, my income is then $5 and my cost of goods sold is $3, leaving a gross profit of $2. So you all want to look for businesses that have really healthy gross profits. But if we follow our way down, okay, the profit and loss statement, we're going to get to a very important line called expenses. So expenses incorporate all of the operating expenses needed to keep the business afloat. These things include rent, payroll, health insurance, office supplies, computers, etc. Basically, everything that goes into making the business operate. And these expenses are extremely important because when you're purchasing a business, when you're consolidating a business, in most occasions, this is the easiest place where you can pay attention and automatically increase the value of the business by hundreds of thousands or maybe even millions of dollars. That is exactly why it's so important that we focus on this expense line a little later on in the video. So after the expense line, we've got other incomes, other sources of income for the business. What else, in addition to just the sales, for instance, of bananas, play a role in increasing the bottom line of my business? Other incomes are extremely important because you want to acquire a business that has more than one income flow. Maybe you acquire a very successful distributor that also happens to do private labeling. Well, that's another source of income. And both of those things go into the income aspect of the profit and loss. Now, last but not least, okay, you have your net operating income, which essentially is your income minus your cost of goods sold, minus your expenses, equals your net operating income. At the end of the day, the net operating income is the income that's going to get divvied up and distributed to the shareholders of the business. This is the true profit. This is what you can expect to earn, what's actually going to get deposited in your bank account. This might be the most important thing in the entire profit and loss statement. So now that you know what a profit and loss is, it's time to talk about why it's super important. The profit and loss is important because not only does it show me the financial stability and health of a business today, but it shows me the past of that business, the trajectory of that business, where we think that business could go in the future under the right management, under the right CEO. You can really think about, by just looking at a profit and loss and placing the right people in that business, how you can exponentially grow the business from where it is to where you want it to be. Normally, the customers of mine that acquire new distribution companies are normally those that take those distribution companies from old owners who are looking to get out of the business. They're looking to cash out. They're looking to retire. So they buy these businesses, okay? And by looking at these profit and losses, they're able to identify strengths and weaknesses. For instance, a weakness could be an expense that the old owner had on the books. A strength could be a product within the warehouse that hasn't moved because it hasn't been marketed or promoted. So when you look at this profit and loss, you really can determine what potential revenue there is for you in the future. And that is why it is super important. And that is why it may be the most important piece of paper, report, document ever to be developed for a business. So now we're going to get into an extremely simplified version of a profit and loss statement that I went ahead and pulled off the internet. I'm going to go ahead and show it right here. The very first line on this profit and loss is the income line. You'll see income being at $2.75 million. The next line on the profit and loss is the cost of goods sold. So the cost of the actual product that was sold, in this case, was $356,000. So if we think back to the banana example that I bought for $3, that would be the cost of goods sold, and that I sold for $5, that would be the income. Now, this company's gross profit is $2.394 million, which is right about 87% gross profit margin. And the way you find your gross profit margin is by dividing the gross profit by the income of the company. Now, the gross profit margin really gives you great insight as to how good the company's margins are. It gives you insight that if you were to increase the marketing expense, if you were to increase your sales value, if you were to increase your top line income, well, guess what? You'd be generating 87% in gross profits. But now, gross profits aren't what you take home. Gross profits are essentially just what you generate. Then you have to deduct the expenses, which are the next line in the profit and loss. So expenses take into account employee expenses, health insurance, office rent, warehouse space, power, right? Water bills, insurance, computers, etc. Everything that goes into making the business operational, everything that goes into the day-to-day operations of that business. Expenses are extremely important because when you're buying a business, when you're consolidating a business, there's quite often a big potential to cut some expenses that are just unnecessary and drastically change and transform your net operating income. So the net operating income for this business that you see in this profit and loss is $929,000. So the company, after paying expenses, after deducting the cost of goods sold, made almost $1 million in net operating income. The net operating income is a great picture as to how what you can expect as an owner to deposit in your bank account should you purchase this business. Essentially, the net operating income is the driving force, the valuation of every small business. Some businesses are valuated at a multiple of 10. So for instance, if this business that you see here was a technology business, it would be worth $10 million. Whereas a food business may be valued at a valuation of 3 to 5x. So it might be valued $3 million to $5 million. Either way, the net operating income really tells you what the business is going to cash flow and what and how healthy that business is going to be moving into the future. The next line that you'll see in the profit and loss is other incomes. Now, I don't know why this profit and loss in particular has it as a separate line item, but I imagine it's because this business has another source of income that does not have any cost of goods sold. So this other source of income would be added to the top line income and then subtract from both of these incomes, the cost of goods sold and the expense, to get the final net operating income, which for this business is $941,000. So by looking at this profit and loss, especially if you're looking at the last 5 years of profit and losses for your business, you can look at that bottom net operating income and take it over the last 5 years so that you can determine just how profitable your business is and how it's becoming and how it's looking and projecting for the future. So the profit, the net operating income of this business is 34%. And the way you know that is simply by taking the net operating income, or $941,000, and dividing it by the top line income, which is $2.75 million. So overall, this business nets 34% on 87% gross profit margins. Okay, so you can tell that this business has a tremendous amount of expenses in between the time it sells the product, okay, and after you pay everybody, pay all the expenses and pay everything. So where the expenses of this business are solely focused in are in office and operating and salary expenditures. So now that you know what a profit and loss is, why it's important, and now you've seen an actual profit and loss, let's get into what you want to look out for if you're going to purchase a distribution company. Well, you want to look out for a company that has great gross profit percentage or gross profit margin. Why? Because the smaller the gross profit margin, the more indicative it is that that company's selling a product that is very competitive. Maybe they sell Keebler snacks and you have 1,000 distributors in the area that sell Keebler snacks. Well, then it just becomes a price bidding war between one distributor and the next and a race to the lowest gross profit margin available. Yet, if you buy a manufacturing company or a company that actually produces its own goods, then essentially its cost of goods sold becomes the raw materials that goes into those finished goods. And raw materials tend to be very cost effective, which means that a company that manufactures, you'll normally see a gross profit margin of anywhere between 50 and 70%. So I would recommend, right, if you're going to go out and buy a distribution company that's not generating a tremendous amount of revenue, I would recommend that you buy either a reseller or distributor that has some product that's solely theirs, right? So they've got exclusivity on that product. Or I would buy a business that manufactures a product that all you have to do is market that product in order to increase the top line income. If you don't do these things and you buy a business that has a really small gross profit margin, then you are at a race to the bottom. You would have to make literally $100 million a year in order to generate, let's say your gross profit margin was 3%, to generate $3 million. So your operation would be so huge to generate so little money, it just wouldn't be worth it. When looking at a profit and loss at a business, you really want to analyze what the expenses are. Because owners of businesses tend to put a bunch of expenses on the business that aren't real business expenses. They also tend to inflate their own salaries. They also tend to buy things that aren't the most intelligent for their business. Why? Just because they can, because they're the owner of the business. Imagine when you take control of this business, those things will all be cut out and all of those expenses will be passed through to your net operating income. So by simply taking over the business, your business just became exponentially more profitable. So that's an easy way to see whether or not the business is being mismanaged. Like imagine if you're a big corporation and on your balance or on your profit and loss, you've got a big expense for corporate jets. And let's say that corporate jet's costing you $10 million a year. Well, if you only use that corporate jet once a year, by cutting that corporate jet, you've just passed $10 million to your net operating income. And by using any multiple, right, your business just went up. The value of that business just went up by, I don't know, a factor of 2 or 3 times. So that's why it's super important that you pay attention to your profit margin and within that profit margin, your expenses. Because I can almost guarantee that the current owners of the business are putting something into those expenses that you could easily take out and increase the value of the business. So now the net operating income is essentially the scorecard. It's the end result of taking all these costs into account, all these expenses, all these revenues, and you get to this net operating income value. The net operating income is super simple. Okay, let's say like in the event of this business, you have a net operating income of $941,000. Okay, this means that if you had 3 shareholders or 4 shareholders, you would divide that net operating income by 3 or 4 to get that dividend that the shareholder is gonna take and deposit into his or her bank account. The net operating income is actually what passes through the business and ends up in the bank of the owners. Okay, so when looking at a business, you really wanna focus on this net operating income. Now remember, the net operating income is a product of the revenues, of the cost of goods sold, of the expenses. So don't get too caught up on that net operating income. Get caught up in the trajectory of the business, what the last 5 years look like. Get caught up in what expenses can you cut because they're just not necessary because the business was mismanaged by the owners. Get caught up in how can you increase the revenues? Who can you sell those products to that could take it to the next level? Because every time you sell a product, you've got an 87% profit margin. These are the things you need to be thinking about when you go buy one of these distribution businesses. And what you do not want to get caught up in, you do not want to get caught up in a business that's a race down to zero where you're making a bunch of money in income, but spending it all on cost of goods sold and expenses. Anyways, I hope this video really brought to light how important a profit and loss is, what it is, exactly how it works. Please take this information. If you have any questions, hit me down in the comments below. If you hated this video, let me know below. If you liked it, give me a big like, a big subscribe. I'm gonna try to pop out content like this every single week. Apart from that, I hope that you have an amazing day. Take care.